And finally tonight, every year at this time, Harvard's Hasty Pudding Club honors two of the biggest names in show business with its Man and Woman of the Year awards. Next week, comedian Steve Martin will pick up his Hasty Pudding Pot for Man of the Year. Earlier this week, the club's choice for Woman of the Year was in town, 76-year-old Lucille Ball. Still funny, still feisty, and as Marcus Jones reports, still the world's most popular redhead.
In Cambridge, Harvard's marching band plays a theme heard around the world. The opening music from the I Love Lucy show. Audiences first heard it 36 years ago, and since then, this questionable redhead has never relinquished her title as the reigning queen of television comedy. At 76, Lucille Ball still knows how to make us laugh.
Wow!
Lucy accepts with pleasure the fact she'll always be remembered as the flaky housewife on I Love Lucy, but her career is not limited to the small screen. She starred on the radio show My Favorite Husband and on Broadway in Wildcat. Since 1933, she has appeared in more than 70 feature films.
Hello. How was heaven when you left?
Tell me, little boy, did you get a whistle or a baseball bat with that suit?
Before she went to Hollywood, Lucy worked in New York as a waitress, a chorus girl, and a model. On the silver screen, she often played comic relief beside some of Hollywood's biggest stars, like Katharine Hepburn and Ginger Rogers, Fred Astaire, and the Marx Brothers. But there are also serious moments, such as in the 1939 movie Five Came Back, where Lucy showed off a sultry, sexy side that put her in the running with Vivian Leigh for the role of Scarlett O'Hara in Gone with the Wind.
What do you consider your ultimate goal in life? A man.
It was on the set of this 1940 picture, Too Many Girls, that Lucy met and literally knocked her future husband, Desi Arnaz, off his feet. The two were married in 1941, and 10 years later, they went on the air with I Love Lucy.
We're having a baby, my baby and me.
Lucy's favorite shows include this one, where she tells Ricky she's pregnant, and of course, The Chocolate Factory.
Well, the writers heard me say one day that I had been down to the farmer's market, and I was intrigued by the stoic lady who sat in a window. We got her to work with me in the show. Now, she had been 20 years in this place at the farmer's market. And she'd been sitting there all of 20 years doing this. Never looking up, never smiling, never changing. The most she did was make a change of the pan. And she came on our set, and she sat down, and they said, we'll call you when it comes time for your rehearsal. She sat there. She looked around. Somebody went over to her and said, well, how do you like it? She says, it's so boring.
There were only 179 episodes made of I Love Lucy in the 6 years the show originally aired on CBS. But some speculate that every minute, someplace, somewhere, someone is watching a Lucy rerun.
Because I love Lucy, yes, I love Lucy, and Lucy loves me.
For the 10 o'clock news, I'm Marcus Jones.